This video walks you through the Forms F version of the PHS Human Subjects and Clinical Trials Information Form. This form is used to collect detailed study-level information for the protocols included in NIH grant applications. I'll show assist data entry screens throughout this video. If you use a system-to-system solution or workspace to prepare and submit your applications, the look and feel of the screens may be different, but the fields and requirements are the same. Before completing the form, first complete the Human Subjects section of the R&R Other Project Information form. The application-level information collected, including whether the application involves human subjects research and exemptions identified across all studies, drive the behavior of this form and are displayed for reference. On the main page of the form, all applicants are required to answer the question, does any of the proposed research in the application involve human specimens and/or data? And the explanation attachment is always available. This allows for scenarios where an application involves both human subjects and human specimens and/or data. The other requested information attachment should only be used when specifically requested in the opportunity or application guide instructions. If you answered no to the human subjects involved question on the other project information form, you're done. No additional information is needed. If you answered yes, you need to provide at least one full detailed study or delayed onset study record. If you anticipate human subjects research will be done, but definite plans for this involvement cannot be described in the application, then you may meet our definition of delayed onset. Entering a delayed onset study is easy. Simply provide a study title, an indication of whether one or more clinical trials are anticipated, and attach a justification. Delayed onset is not the same as delayed start, where the information is known up front, but the work is not done in the initial budget period. We expect a full record for delayed start studies. Now let's look at a full study record. Study records are broken down into five sections. I've marked the fields required for human subject studies with an HS icon, and the additional fields you must complete if doing a clinical trial with a CT icon to help visualize requirements as we walk through the study record. Section 1 includes basic information and must be completed for all study records, both those with and without clinical trials. It includes a study title up to 600 characters, which must be unique within the application, study level exemption code information, a clinical trial questionnaire. If you answer yes to all four questions, the study will be considered a clinical trial, unless you're proposing clinical trial research experience under a clinical trial not allowed funding opportunity. Since study records are only created when human subjects are involved, the first question, does the study involve human participants, defaults to yes and is not editable. And finally, you have the option of providing a clinicaltrials.gov identifier, often referred to as an NCT number. If you have an NCT number, ASSIST and some systems-to-system solutions allow you to exchange data with clinicaltrials.gov to reduce data entry and provide more consistent information between systems. The additional sections in the study record are designed to lead you through our data collection requirements in a structured way. This ensures each item has been given appropriate consideration and that we have the data necessary in a consistent format for review and oversight of the study. Section 2 is study population characteristics. You must complete this section for all studies unless exemption 4 applies. All studies must include at least one condition or focus of study, eligibility criteria, min and max age limits, recruitment status, the enrollment of first participant, which helps us monitor clinicaltrials.gov registration compliance, attachments for inclusion of individuals across the lifespan, inclusion of women and minorities, and a recruitment and retention plan. The study timeline attachment is only required for clinical trial studies, and finally, at least one inclusion enrollment report. For each inclusion enrollment report, you must provide a study title, indicate whether an existing data set or resource will be used, and whether the enrollment location type is domestic or foreign. And there are separate tables for planned and cumulative enrollment data. Section 3 is the Protection and Monitoring Plan section. All studies must include a Protection of Human Subjects attachment and answer the question regarding multi-site studies. NIH applicants no longer need to provide single IRB plans for multi-site studies, although the form text has not yet been changed. The Data and Safety Monitoring Plan attachment and question about the use of a Data Safety Monitoring Board are required for studies involving clinical trials, and the overall structure of the study team attachment is optional for all studies. Section 4 is the Protocol Synopsis, which is only for studies involving independent clinical trials. It includes a detailed description of the objectives of the study, a series of additional fields related to study design, and the ability to provide at least one but up to 50 outcome measures. As part of the Forms F update, we added the question, is this an applicable clinical trial under the Food and Drug Administration Amendments Act? And the section closes with a dissemination plan attachment. The final section, Section 5, is for other clinical trial-related attachments, which, not surprisingly, is only used in clinical trial study records and only when an attachment is specifically requested in the funding opportunity. We've seen how our PHS Human Subjects and Clinical Trials Information Form uses structured data fields to lead you through key requirements, collects the information needed for appropriate study oversight, provides a consistent format for reviewers and staff to quickly find key information, and aligns with clinicaltrials.gov for data exchange between systems. For field-by-field guidance for completing the PHS Human Subjects and Clinical Trials Information Form, check out the resources on our How to Apply application guide page on the grants.nih.gov website.